and today we are at the infamous Three Floyds Dark Lord Day. Let's do this thing.
So Dark Lord Day is a day of its own. I mean, there's no other fest in the country that compares.
I love Dark Lord Day. I am so glad to be here today. This is a fantastic beer.
The beer is incredible. This beer is really good.
It's my third year.
Fantastic. Better than last year even.
For myself, this is my third year here.
I love Dark Lord Day. Fifth year in a row.
I've been coming here for about 5-6 years in a row now.
I love Dark Lord Day. I've been here 5 times. Twice pregnant.
I just love that this beer has brought so many people together. Eating great food, drinking good beer, meeting great people. It's a wonderful event.
I love everything they do. Their food, their beer, everything is wonderful. They're really the only reason to come to Indiana.
Well, maybe not the only reason, but certainly an awesome one. In fact, Dark Lord Day attracts almost 10,000 attendees to the one-day beer release, with the $180 tickets selling out almost immediately. To find out more about this truly unique event, we caught up with Chris Bogus, who's been the head brewer at Three Floyds since 2006.
Welcome to Dark Lord Day 2017, new and improved in May.
I'm excited about it. Yes. This is my first Dark Lord Day ever.
Welcome.
Thank you. I'm excited to be here. Tell me a little bit about like the origins of Dark Lord Day. How did this all come to be?
Back in the day, at Flossmoor Station, they made this really strong stout beer, and I forget the name of it, but Nick was like, I can make a beer stronger than that. So it kind of was a competition, like an internal competition. I don't think he told them. And it was like a 90-gallon batch, like 2003, I think, was the first batch. And then in 2004, we started having Dark Lord Day.
And now it's come to be thousands and thousands of people come to Munster, Indiana. Yep. Can you tell me a little bit about that beer?
It's just a big, ignorant, like Russian Imperial Stout, and then you know, all the barrel-aged stuff takes it even to another level.
It's about, what is it, 14% alcohol, I believe. You got a taste of chocolate, vanilla, cinnamon, soy sauce, which is a little weird, but it works. But it's a very smooth stout, and it's why everyone is here today.
The beer is very heavy. It's very, has an alcohol bite that I just love. It's a great beer, and I really enjoy it.
You get 4 of these, and you get a random tote bag, and the variant is completely random. So you either get a variant or 2 older bottles of this. We ended up actually getting 2 Hanjis and 2 French Vanilla Moisha, which everyone was freaking out because it's a random beer selection this year.
As you come out the door, and it's not just me, there's a lot of people that are like, they missed out on a certain variant, or they want to get like all the variants, like a collection of them. So they'll sell beer, or they'll offer money up to buy beer, and then they'll get those variants that they want.
Some 22-ounce bombers of Dark Lord have been reportedly resold for more than $400. But Dark Lord is only one of the amazing brews created by Three Floyds, which was started in 1996 by Nick Floyd with the help of his brother and father.
Three Floyds is considered one of the best breweries in the world, not only in the United States, not only in Indiana, on the planet. Why do you think that is?
I don't know, really. To be honest, I think our beer is really good. We like to keep it real. I think people appreciate that. Like, it's kind of outer body experience. It's strange.
You just put your head down every day and keep doing what you're doing.
That's right, I'm grinding.
Being the brewmaster here at Three Floyds, take me through kind of your mainstays.
Start with Alpha King, because that's the original beer, the flagship. It's a pretty full-bodied, kind of almost an amber pale ale, 6.66% alcohol. And the BU's happened to be 66 as well. Then we've got Gumball Head, which is, you know, sort of approachable. It's pretty hoppy, but it's easy drinker, and it's named after Gumball Head the cat, the comic book. And then Yum Yum, which is one of our newer beers that we use a lot of German varietals with that.
Delicious.
Yeah. Zombie Dust is another one of our pale ales. That's got a lot of citra hops, so it's real kind of dank and pretty easy to drink, good balance.
I love Zombie Dust. Zombie Dust all day. Give me as much as they have, I want it.
Zombie Dust is fantastic.
I think I'm like the coolest wife ever because we do have a Zombie Dust mural above the kegerator in our kitchen.
I mean, I'm definitely a dust brother, as a lot of people in the Chicago community would say. Like, ISO dust, looking for dust every day. If I see dust on a shelf, even if it's like 3-4 months old, I'm getting a dust.
To stay ahead in the competitive craft beer world, Three Floyds hired famed brewmaster Todd Hogg in October of 2016.
All right, I'm the luckiest girl in the world. I'm at 2017 Dark Lord Day at Three Floyds, hanging out with Todd himself. How are things going?
Good. There's a bunch of people here. The weather is, for once, really, really nice. You know, this is my first time being at Dark Lord as an employee at Three Floyds. So to see how much work and time and energy and care the staff puts in is mind-blowing. Like the attention to detail that everyone just chips in and helps. It's not, no one like makes them do it, they just do it. And they're all working the event and we're managing the people. It's amazing, so.
What do you think makes Three Floyds so special?
Well, obviously they're branding. I hate that term, but that's, I don't know what sums it up any better. The labels and the just the names, and it's very much more pointed at Nick's interests. Like, I don't even know what half the names.
It's a little nerdy.
Right, exactly. Well, that's just it. It's like no one realizes that there is actually, they're not just pulled out of a hat. They have some unique story behind them, and it might not make sense to anybody else but Nick or Chris or a brewer.
Up there. Tell me a little bit about that.
So 5 years ago we played, I mean, I've been in this band since the late 80s. I joined Power Mad when I was in high school. And so we've, you know, been on and off for since then. And we played here 5 years ago at Inside when it was, the bands were still inside. And so now the production is, the whole event's gotten bigger. So we're playing outside on the big stage, which is really exciting.
Besides the mind-blowing heavy metal music, one of the other hallmarks of Dark Lord Day is bottle sharing.
Yeah, so that's one of the big things about Dark Lord Day is kind of the sharing and bringing beers from all over the world. So Dark Lord is definitely a focus here, but you can bring some things from your region and really enjoy other beers from other places outside of Indiana.
It's amazing. I mean, you don't even have to know anybody, and people just love to hand out beers and share. You get to meet people all the time from all across the country. It's just, it's a festival like no other, really.
I've seen many of people from at least Pennsylvania, Oklahoma. Like, I met a couple people from California, a couple people from Florida.
You know, they get to try beers you never get to try before.
And we tried a ton of different beers that we didn't have. I mean, we brought, like, combined 16 different beers. And we've had probably 40 different beers today, which is awesome.
The sharing is one of the most fun parts of the event. It's sharing beer from all over the country, enjoying it, and then coming back and enjoying some more Three Floyds.
In fact, I brought the Dark Lord with me right here.
I just had my mind blown at Dark Lord Day. Cheers! Cheers!